Hello and welcome. In this video, we are applying our knowledge of plugins by creating an instance of a block plugin. Here's what we will achieve by the end of this video. Remember the RSVP form we have been accessing at /RSVP list demo? Well, it is now time to begin evolving that form into a block so we can display it in various places on our site. To do this, in our module code, we need to create a plugin instance of type block. We'll learn the correct annotation to use, and we'll experience where this code needs to be placed. In this video, we will create the block using placeholder text, and in upcoming videos, we will replace the placeholder text with the actual form. This process ensures that we have a strong foundational understanding of how block plugin instances are created. Before we code, let's first refresh our minds on the plugin concept. Recall that blocks in Drupal are instances of the block plugin type. Now, although there are technically multiple ways to register plugins with Drupal, nearly all block plugins in Drupal use annotations to register themselves and describe their metadata. This means that the Drupal Block Manager scans your module's classes for a class that contains the @block annotation. This annotation is a comment in a specific format right above the class declaration. We'll see this in action in just a bit. Great. Also recall that blocks are not the only type of plugin available with Drupal. This means that how we use annotations to declare an instance of a block plugin can be applied to plugins of other types. As a short list, there are also field formatters, field widgets, block visibility conditions, migrate plugins. Those are all examples of plugins that use annotations to register themselves with Drupal. Well, that's enough theory for now. Have your code editor ready to go with the RSVP list module loaded. See you there soon. Hi again. Okay, the first thing we need to do is create the file which will contain the class for the RSVP block. On your own, try to deduce the directories that need to be created for our block class to be placed in the correct location. Plugins must be created in the plugin directory under SRC. Let's create that now. First, in the SRC directory of RSVP list, create a new directory called plugin with a capital P. Remember that correct capitalization matters for PSR4 discovery. Capital P L U G I N. It is within this plugin directory that all of your plugins need to be defined within their appropriately named subdirectory. For us, we are creating an instance of a block plugin. So let's now create another new directory called block with a capital B. B-L-O-C-K. Fantastic, nice work. Now let's create a new file called rsvpblock.php. RSVP, all capitals, with a capital B-L-O-C-K.php. Nice, open it up. Obviously, the first thing we need to do is, at the top of the file, include the full PHP tag along with the @file_doc_block. Cool. Next, declare the namespace. Remember blank lines above and below it. Continuing on, let's bring in the existing functionality we will eventually implement with these use statements. Excellent. This brings us to the core learning of this video, creating a block class with its appropriate annotation. First, declare the RSVP block form class, of which this file is named after. Class RSVP block extends block base. Pay attention to the closing curly bracket of the class and correct spelling and capitalization in the class names. So, in order for this RSVP block class to be identified as a block instance, it needs to have the correct annotation above it. So type this comment exactly as it is shown. So this @block text lets Drupal plugin discovery process know this is a block plugin. It also lets Drupal know that the system ID of this block is RSVP underscore block, and the admin label of the block is simply the RSVP block. Seriously, great work from you in understanding this. Annotations are not difficult, but they do need to be done correctly. Finally, for now, let's have this class return some basic markup text so we can see that the block is identified by Drupal. In an upcoming video, we will replace this markup text with the RSVP form. So, inside the RSVP block class, place this build method, complete with the @inherit.docblock. Fabulous, you are awesome. This concludes the code required to define and instantiate a block plugin type. To review, the text markup content of the block that will be displayed is my RSVP list block, and the administrative label, and therefore the default title of the block, will be the RSVP block. Its system ID is RSVP underscore block. Double check your code, save the file, and then head on over to your site. Now back at our site, be sure to flush the cache as the first step. Afterward, let's place our new block in the sidebar first region. Head to Structure, Block Layout, and then scroll down to the sidebar first region and click Place Block. Here, we can locate the RSVP block. Remember that the admin label text shown here is from the annotation of the RSVP block class we just created. If you do not see the block listed here, make sure you have flushed the cache and be sure to check the location of rsvpblock.php along with the correct spelling and capitalization of all directories. And it is crucial that the annotation of the RSVP block class be typed correctly. When you are able to locate the RSVP block, be sure to place it with a click. Woohoo! Here, we can see the admin label text from the code annotation as the default title. Leave all the defaults of the block. Display the title and do not set any visibility rules. Click Save Block. And upon returning, scroll down to click Save Blocks. Yes, here we go. Head back to the homepage and yeah! Here is our block with the markup we expect. Super job correctly implementing a block plugin instance. Give yourself some credit for achieving another milestone in Drupal module development. Take a look at the resources if you wish. Happy learning.